Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today I am planning on doing several head swaps. Also, as you saw in the intro, I have a lot of fashion packs. And I'm gonna start right away because there's a lot of those here, as you can see. I'm going to first off show you this girl. You saw her packaging. She is, you know, this girl, the, what is she, floral teal, made to move yoga. And when I got, I ordered these three recently, and when I got them, I opened one, because I was really curious to see how this bun will look once it's down. It actually looked like that, like Marge Simpson. And I tried to boil wash it and, you know, make something out of it. But sadly, it's not gonna work. Because even though, you know, I can give her a pixie, because I really like the face. She has very cute face. And I like it, but do you see how poorly she is rooted? Her hair has to be slicked at all times, because otherwise the minute, you know, it's not, you can see her scalp. It's just she's been very thinly rooted, and I don't have time to re-root her now, so I decided that I'm gonna use her as a donor. And I think that these two are gonna be I think they will be a decent match. This girl has a little bit lighter skin tone than this one, but I think that it will actually work. So how do we head swap? First off, I do have a video, you know, especially for that on my channel, but I'm gonna show you again, just this time, you know, real quick. And sorry, let me get the shoes off. Ouch, these shoes are very pretty, but they're very hard to get off, and I don't recommend them for made to move those, because they're really tight here and they can pull out the feet of the made to move those. First off, I remove the clothing. Then you need, this is my method, there are other methods, but this is, you know, what I have found is most comfortable for me. I wrap the hair and, you know, the head of the doll in a towel, and because I don't want to remove her earrings, I'm gonna turn them like so. I'll do that with the hair. And I will wrap like that. Just so this part of her face is visible. Oops. And then I'm gonna use a hair dryer to heat the hair. The head, not the hair. It's very important to not heat the hair, because you're gonna melt it. This is why we are wrapping it with this old clean towel. And now that it is squishy enough. And now we fail. This was not supposed to happen, but I think her neck was already cracked. Let's see what happened here. Yeah, I could see this part of the neck was open. You know what? I kind of fixed it. I'm gonna have to glue it here, but yeah. Not that this body is important. Now let's see. Good. No damage on her hair. That's good. Now I will do the same with this head. And I'm gonna pop it off. I got it out. Weirdly enough, this doll also has very big, you know, crack here. And I didn't do that. It was like that. And now I will just compare the two anchors, because sometimes the anchors are different. And I found out that there are anchors that are a little smaller here. And if you cut these, your head could get wobbly. This happened once, but from that moment on, I'm being very careful. I'm gonna just get that off like so. Does this color fit? You know what? I think it does. I think that she is actually a good match. You know, it's not perfect, but yeah, it works. I'm happy with it. Sorry for shaking the camera. Okay. We have one girl ready over here. These are gonna go in the spare parts bin. Who should be next? I think I'm gonna do this one next, and the mermaid. These two, yeah, It's gonna be a good match. I really like that wave of Dreamtopia mermaids. The bodies are, you know, they're nice, you know, at least they can sit. But I really like the faces and the hair. So, first off, I'm gonna remove her little headpiece. Let's see. Oh, there is another kajinker over here. Like so. I will fish these out after, you know, later. And now let's blow dry. I hope that's enough because I'm afraid not to melt the hair. Yeah, it's enough. There we have that beautiful head. I'm gonna leave it here. And then let's do this head. Tonight I'm really struggling. Now the head. Let's put it on. I really like her. What do you guys think? Do you like her? Cut that out. I think that she is very, very nice. Cool. We're gonna try the clothing on her in a moment. Let's just swap the other girls. Next we're gonna do this one and this one. Doesn't wanna stop. Oh, I heated it too much. It's hot now, but it's gonna be easier. Yep, a lot more easier. Good. And now the fashionista. I've been collecting these fashionistas for a while, and also I've been collecting made to move bodies for them, and you know, finally I got a good amount of both, and I decided that I'm gonna share it with you guys. Hopefully it is interesting for you as it is for me. Blow dryer. Wow, very hot. And by the way, if you want to remove the earrings while it is hot, you can just, you know, pop them out. But I don't really want to because they remain with holes in their ears and I don't like that. But yeah, it's pretty easy to get it off. You know what? I will take hers out. I like the other ones, you know, the triangle ones, but I will get these off because you can see this is flaking off, and with time it's gonna completely flake off, and I don't need to have to deal with that. I will have to find her some other earrings. And let's put her on the body while the head is still hot. It's gonna be much easier. That's a nice transformation. You know, she was, that was a tall body, and now she is a curvy. And yeah, it really suits her. The hair crinkled, but at least I didn't burn it. It just crinkled. It's gonna be easy fix. A little bit of water. I'll show you in a minute how, you know, I fixed them. You know, I fixed the hairs because they get disheveled while I am using the hair dryer. Let's get these shoes off of that body. Next I will do this girl. She's almost wearing original stuff other than her pants. She had very nice blue skirt, but I robbed her out of it. I gave it to another doll who is in my dollhouse. Now let's wrap her nicely. And the body that I'm going to use for her is the pink top made to move, you know, from the first wave. But I already have the head removed because I got it separately from this and the body over there. And I removed the heads. When I got them, they were secondhand and they needed washing. So while I was washing them, I popped the heads off. Now let's use the heat. Pretty hot again. Come on. And oh, this is very hot indeed. I keep saying that it's hot and then I keep touching it. I'm checking the face. Yeah, it's good. No damage. That's good. Let's pop her on this body. It's again not a perfect match. You know, her face is a little more yellow than the body, but I haven't found a perfect match for this skin tone. And I think that it actually works pretty nice for her. And the last girl is this dolly. She is not fashionista. So this is a fashionista mermaidia. Not mermaidia, dreamtopia mermaid. And this one was a doctor, I think, from the career Barbies. And this is my favorite face mold. And then I really like her hair. It's, you know, very white blonde, and that's very beautiful. At first I was keeping her for, you know, I wanted to find a curvy body with that skin tone, but that turned out very, you know, very hard for me for some reason. And so she's gonna get the classic body type, but she's gonna have a special feature, and you'll see in a minute. I just wanna safely pop the head off and I will show you and I will explain about her body. that should be enough. More than enough, I would say. Very hot. Whew. I got it. Let's get this body off. We're not gonna need the towel anymore. Let me just... The desk is very hot too. Everything is hot. Anyways, this is the body that I'm going to give her. And essentially, this is a custom body that I customized. Maybe you know the fashionista with the prosthetic leg. This is the prosthetic leg from that fashionista. But I cut it to pieces, basically. And with the help of my father-in-law, I put it back together. And now I have a made-to-move body with prosthetic leg. This is the other foot, you know, from here, because it had no articulation down there. And yeah, I'm very happy with how that worked, and you know, it is pretty unique, and I'm very happy to have it, you know, like that. Okay, so I will make a made-to-move doll with a prosthetic leg. Basically what I did, this was that fashionista with the prosthetic leg. I removed the leg. It's very it was very easy to remove it because it is made to be removed. So I just popped it out. And what was in here, there we have it. It was this piece. It was in there. Like so. And it was screwed in there. And so this thing snaps in there and holds the leg. Then what I did, I took it apart. I took my X-Acto knife and I just cut this, basically. You can see. Then the next step was I cut. This was the foot that was there. I cut it. And I'm gonna put the made to move leg so she can, you know, pose better and be able to wear high heels, essentially. Now, what I'm gonna do, this is the made to move doll. You can very easily remove the legs and I suppose the hands. I haven't tried it because I haven't had the need of the made to move dolls, because this is, you know, how they are put together with a joint like that. And in order to do it, you just need to heat that part up and pull. But you really need to heat it up very nicely so it gets kind of softer, and just yank it out of there while you're holding this part. You know, you're yanking this, not this, because this I think also can come apart, and I'm not sure how easy it's gonna be to get it back on. Anyways, you see I have marked here because, as you can see, this part of the leg is as long as this with the peg here. And that means if I try to put that in there, it is going to make her leg, you know, too long, it's not gonna fit. And when that was in there, you know, it was this much deep in. So what I need to do is I need to cut the leg from here, screw that on there or glue it on there. I'm not sure how it's gonna happen. I'll see if this thing is hollow or not. Then I will be able to put that part and to put that together. I also shaved a little bit here so it can bend. I'm gonna need to drill a hole in this and in this and to put something going through there so, you know, it can be a joint. And then also I'm gonna need to drill a hole in here so that can go in there. I am not gonna do that by myself. I'm going to ask my father-in-law to help me in the garage, essentially. And I will show you the end result. Because, you know, it's gonna be work with power tools and I'm not very good at it. I know what has to be done, so I will just, you know, ask him to help me. Be right back. Here she is with the elastics on the joints and I painted the leg with the silver paint. So, you know, it's no longer this dull gray color, but it's nice and shiny. I hope that, you know, I was kind of able to explain how the leg, you know, what was put together. I know that I'm not very good at explaining. But it actually worked and it wasn't so hard. It is a little wobbly, but I will put some elastics on it. And, you know, most importantly, it is very poseable. Let's get the anchor shorter and put the head on the body. That's very cute. So we have 5 new made to move dolls who were previously Fashionista, Mermaidia and Barbie careers Barbie. I will dress them up in the outfits that I got and I will show them to you. I had to go to Sofia for some things. The bodies were ordered online, but I had to go to Sofia to stock on some things. And there was a big promotion of... Sorry, I lost the top. No, I didn't. Here it is. Of these fashion packs, they were like $2 each because, as you saw in the beginning of the video, the packaging was very much destroyed, but I don't mind. And I'm very happy that I got these 3 dresses because I see so much potential in them for photo shoots. And I'm not gonna try them on the dolls, maybe. I'm not 100% sure, we'll see. I think that I'm gonna keep them for photo shoots, and if you wanna see them, you know, on those in the future, you can go and follow me on Instagram. But yeah, I got this fashion pack, and I've been wanting this fashion pack for a very long time. I don't particularly care, you know, for the skirt, but I've been, you know, really wanting this shirt specifically. And then on regular prices, there was the Roxy fashion packs, which I am going to get out of this packaging right now. I've been wanting these Roxy fashion packs ever since, you know, I saw that they came out. Because of the new packaging, of course, it's very cool. And also because I really like pastel colors, and they're very pastely, and I think that they're very nice, at least they look very nice. We're gonna check that right now. And I don't know if I left it in there, but I had put this in one of the fashion packs packets. It's just something that I had in our place in Sofia. It's a handmade dress for a curvy doll. It's nothing special, but I had made it, you know, in Sofia in a very long time, and it was, you know, there all by itself, and I decided to, you know, get it here where some doll can actually... Getting this out of the packet isn't so easy. The cardboard, it's a little thick, and getting it out, it's not so easy, but it's not the end of the world. And you can always store your clothing in that. Oh, and I'm very happy for this backpack. I know that it looks maybe too small or something, but I have one like it, just purple, and it's always a very nice, you know, last touch to an outfit. It helps finish the outfit, so I'm very happy to have a second one, and I would like to have every color of the rainbow of that backpack. If it's possible, please, Mattel. So these are shorts. I think that they might be for the curvy. We're gonna check them out. The shorts are pretty nice. But I like that top a lot more. Yeah, that's a very nice piece, and very versatile. It can be combined with a lot of things. We have a scrunchie, you know, we have it in a lot of other fashion packs. I don't mind, it's a cute accessory. And then we have a hat, and I really love doll hats, but it has so many kajinkers in it. Can I cut the kajinker without destroying the hat? Sweet! Very nice beanie. Then there is this one. The accessory is sunglasses. I think that I have these, but in... I don't have. Sorry, ne is no in Bulgarian. It's late in the night, and, you know, my English isn't very strong right now, but I really wanted to do that. I couldn't wait anymore. So I was saying I don't have them. They look like another pair of sunglasses, but I don't have them. And again, this purse, what's called bum bag, it is like this piece. I have a dark blue one and a red one. The red one is from the Wonder Woman fashion packs, and the dark blue one I think is from one of the BMRs. And when I got them, I really didn't think that I was gonna like them, but it turns out they're very nice for a lot of different outfits, and I'm very happy that they have another color. Can I not cut my fashions? Thank you very much. Yep. That's pretty nice. Very nice shirt. And this is a fluffy skirt. Again, so many jinkers. It has no stretch. I can't tell who it will fit. We will try it on. And the last one of the Roxy fashion packs actually has shoes in it. Sorry for the dog. And I really like these shoes. I have them, I think, from the Barbie Extra. But these ones have the Roxy logo on them, so I'm happy to have them. Then there is a little gray bracelet. Let's put it there with the other accessories. And a little dress. And it's a very nice dress. I really like this one too. Okay, I'm gonna pause. I'm gonna dress the dolls and I'll be right back. Okay, so I did a little bit of dressing up, and I hate that skirt. I'm not gonna. I like the fabric, but I tried it on this doll and this looks like, I don't know, it's not my thing. If you're wondering what that is, it's hair product, hair conditioner. Just, you know, this much hair conditioner and then this much fabric softener and then water to the top, and I spray the hair of the dolls and I brush it through and I just leave it in, and it helps with frizzy hair. It detangles, it makes their hair smell very nicely. I will start with this girl. I gave her old pants, and these are actually slim can pants. I didn't get any shoes because, you know, they're in the other end of the room and I didn't really feel like going. But I think that this outfit really suits her. She looks, you know, like she's going to a concert or something. And I think that I have decided that I'm gonna name her Marna, because she looks like a Marna, you know. She looks a badass, kind of. Very, you know, how can I say it? Very resourceful. Again, sorry, my English is sleeping, but yeah. With this awesome red hair and, I don't know, this beautiful smile and dimples, and something about her just... I really like the name. By the way, shout out to Marna from Dolls Rescued. But yeah, I have decided that her name is gonna be Marna, and we'll see what her role is going to be. I have a comic that is ongoing and it's in the Bulgarian Facebook dolly group that we have, and sadly it's only in Bulgarian because, you know, I write it only in Bulgarian. I should translate it and I should make a page for, you know, its own page, but who knows when I'm gonna do that. I'm very happy for the shirt, and I'm very happy that she's finally made to move. And I forgot to mention it because I assumed that everybody has watched my previous videos, but that's not true. I did repaint her lips, and if you want to see a before and after, you can go and check one of my previous videos. I showed that there. Then we have this girl with the Roxy fashions, and this skirt. Look at, she is not she, it, the skirt is not she, the skirt is it, I think. Again, the English is wanting to fall asleep, and I'm wanting to fall asleep, but I'm not gonna, because I just wanna, you know, show you these things, and I don't know when, if not now. But anyway, the skirt is for a curvy doll, but you can velcro it like that because this material is fluffy and it, the velcro catches on it, so you know, it has potential. You can put it on a curvy, and you can actually put it on the classic made to move body because of the fabric. And this purse bum bag, I really like it. The glasses are really nice. You can see the doll's eyes through them, which, you know, is very nice. And I think that she looks like a Julia to me. She just has the face of a Julia. Again, another name that I really like. And you know, some dolls, they just, when you unbox them, they tell you what their name is gonna be. And yeah, she told me a long time ago that she's gonna be a Julia. And I really love everything about her. Especially her eye shape. You know, the way that the eyes go up. Very beautiful. Very happy to have her. Expect pictures on Instagram. You know, photo shoots with all of them, of course. The next girl, again, wearing a combination of the Roxy fashion packs and the backpack from that fashion pack. The little beanie, it actually looks pretty nice. I think it suits her. I don't have a name for her. Some dolls tell you their names, and I really struggle with some of the dolls. So if you have maybe something with the color of her hair, she could be a Billy. You know, because of the green and black hair. I'm not 100% sold on the name, but I really like the fashion pack. The pants are 100% for a curvy, but I'm happy because my curvy girls don't have too many shorts, and you know, they usually make them just dresses and skirts. I mean Mattel. And now I have a pair of shorts for summer photo shoots, which is awesome. But I noticed a problem with that made to move body. I cannot bend this joint and this joint, and I have tried, I pushed it, I hurt myself trying to push it, and I have like 10 made to move, or 11, now maybe 15 made to move dolls, and I have 2 or 3 more on that specific body. And I know that the first time, you know, pressing that joint is always a little hard, but it never has been this hard. I think that it's just defective, which is gonna be a little sad, but anyways, it is better than the articulation that she had before. All of the other joints work as intended. She's just not gonna be able to, yeah, to really touch her face, because this joint allows her to, you know, touch her face. Maybe with time I will be able to bend it. Let's hope. But I'm really happy to have made her made to move, and I'm gonna think of name. And if not, you know, if I don't think of better name, she's gonna be a Billy. Then the next girl, I have her name, I have her story and everything. She's the sister of my main girl. Her name is Caroline. And I said that I wasn't gonna try this dress on, but I figured that I don't have enough fashions, you know, new different fashions without it here. So, and I realized that I have perfect shoes for it, so I decided that, you know, it's gonna look very nicely on Caroline. Plus I wanted to test how her leg will look in high heels, and I'm very happy it really worked. And I was very much afraid that one leg is gonna be shorter than the other, but it's not. At least if it is, it's not very visible, so that's good. And I'm very happy. Hopefully I will soon introduce her in the story as my main girl's, you know, sister. I haven't decided. No, she's gonna be the younger sister. Yeah. Anyways, that's her. Then this girl, I don't have a name for her yet. I will have to think of something. But yeah, this dress, I think it's gonna also fit curvy very nicely. And it's gonna be a little longer on curvy, because, you know, it is kind of shortish on a regular, you know, classic body, but it's nice. And the purple and the blue goes really nicely with her hair. She has very beautiful face. The more I, you know, look at her, the more I like her, and the more I'm happy that I was able to give her this body. The only thing that I'm thinking, maybe I'm gonna repaint her lips. So yes, I did repaint her lips in a purple color, and I decided to name her Maeve. But and I did record it here, but this video is way too long, so I'm gonna tell you goodbye and thank you so much for watching before, you know, this video has reached an hour. And I'll see you on my next video. Bye bye.